Hey everyone, in today's video, we'll be exploring everything that you need to know about composable previews in Jetpack Compose, from setting up previews to advanced customization. And I will show you how you instantly visualize your UI previews without running your app. Let's dive in and make your development process more smoother and more efficient. First, go to the description box where you can find my GitHub repository link. Download the project and open up into your Android Studio. So it will look something like this. Here we are having package structure, naming normal, then we are having view model. So basically in this video, I'm going to tell you everything that you need to know about composable previews. And also I'm going to discuss one of the complex process in which you are passing view model and using dagger hilt. So let's begin with very simple example. So in the normal package, we are having card item. So this is our composable and I want to see its preview. So in order to see the preview, we are having annotation naming preview. So simply use it. And here you can see this is our composable. All right. Now in this preview, we are having a lot of parameters. So first we are having name. So let's give name to this composable preview, Virat Kohli. And here you can see card item Virat Kohli, and Virat Kohli is the name that we just gave. Next we are having show background. So basically if you want to also see the background, then you can use show background parameter and simply pass true or false depending according to your need. So when I pass true, here you can see now our card item has also background. So if you want to show the background, you can use true. And if you don't want to see the background, then you can simply pass false. It's totally up to you. Next, we are having show system UI. And if you are passing this thing true, now it will basically it will show you how your composable looks like in the real time device. So this is a behavior of our composable in real device. Now we are having API level. So if you are passing API level 12, you can see the status bar got changed, because previously when we are having a lower SDK versions Android devices, then status bar will something look like this. Now today's API level have this kind of status bar. So if you want to see the API level changes, then you can use API level in your previews. Now suppose your application is used by some person whose eyesight is not very good. So what he can do, he can simply increase the font scale. So now it is our duty to know how our composable work if some person eventually increase the font scale. So for that we are having here font scale parameter. So here you can pass 3f. You can see this is a behavior of 3x font scale. Now you can simply manipulate this thing according to your requirement. So for time being, I'm gonna pass 1f. All right. And next we are having here device. So let's use device. And in this devices, we are having a lot of devices like foldable devices, normal devices, pixel devices. So you can create all the previews one by one according to your requirement. So I'm going to use here foldable devices. Here you can see, and our composable will look something like this in foldable devices. Okay. And if you notice here, we are having a lot of things, pixel, XL, tablet. So let's see tablet. So this is a behavior of our composable in tablets. All right, so I'm gonna use here pixel XL. This looks fine. Next we are having locale. So HI, so HI basically represent Hindi. This will change our text, because in your resources, if you open up resources in the values, I'm having two string files. The first one for the Hindi version and the second one is for our normal one, basically the English one. So due to that reason, when I use your local HI, it will simply use the Hindi version. Now if I use your EN, that means it will simply use the English string resource file. So by using this locale, you can actually see the previews of your different language. So next we are going to talk about width DP. So when you give the width 300, it will adjust your composable within this given width. Next we are having height, let's say 500. So it will try to adjust the composable with the given height. All right, so we are pretty much done. We are only left with a UI mode, but in order to show the UI mode, and UI mode is actually used to see the dark mode and light mode. So let's do that. Remove this width and height. So in order to show the light and dark mode, what I'm going to do over here, I'm going to create a composable and call this card item preview and use on the top preview over here. I'm using show background true, and also I'm using show system UI true. Now I'm going to use UI mode. So in order to use UI mode, what we are going to do over here, we are using preview theme. So this preview theme is actually coming from our UI package theme. So here you can see on the bottom, we are having preview theme. So this thing is actually used in order to show the preview of light mode and dark mode. So in the preview theme, I'm going to simply use my card item. And in the UI mode, we are having a lot of option here. You can see, if you want to see the night mode, you can use a UI mode night. Yes, simply press enter. Here you can see, this is the behavior of our composable in night mode. And if you want to see the light mode, you can use your UI mode night. No. So this is our behavior of a composable in the light mode. So if you want to see the dark mode and light mode, you can use this approach. So we are having one more parameter which I left, which is group. So if you want to create a group of composables, then you can use group parameter. All right, so we are pretty much done with the preview things. Now it's time to go in our view model package, and in this view model package we are having composable preview for view model. And in this composable we have passed fake view model, and when you open your fake view model, here you can see we are having UI state, we are having a function get data which actually use use case, fake use case. And when you open this fake use case, so this is a very simple function which eventually replicate the behavior of REST API call. Okay, so now go to your fake view model, and based on this fake use case emission, I will update my UI state. Okay, and this is our UI state. Now go back to your composable preview for view model, and here I'm gonna use preview. Let's see what will happen. So this preview is not working, and the reason behind this is when you pass any parameter which is not initialized by default in your composable, then preview won't work for that case. Okay, so what we are going to do over here, I'm going to create a different composable and call this fake composable preview for view model content. That's it. And within this, I'm going to use fake composable preview for view model. So in order to pass fake view model, I will create fake view model on the top with the help of filled view model, and the type would be fake view model, and simply pass it. Now when I use preview annotation, show background true and show system UI is also true. Now simply use split mode. So here you can see it is not able to show me the preview. When you click onto this icon, the problem is this preview uses a view model. A view model often trigger operation not supported by compose preview, such as database access, IO operation or network request. You can read more about. Basically, long story short, it says view model is not supported by our previews because view model contain a lot of things like IO operation, network operation. So due to that reason, it is not able to show you the preview. So what you can do, so what I usually did in my project, I simply remove this thing. I'm gonna cut it out and create a new composable, call it content. And within this content, I'm gonna paste it. And the requirement of this content would be UI state. So simply pass your UI state. Okay, so now instead of using this fake composable preview for view model preview, I'm gonna use my content. So pass your content, and the requirement of content is not view model, it's UI state. So we can simply pass UI state. If you want to show the loading event, you can use here loading is equal to true. And now when you open up, refresh it. Okay, again the problem is view model. So what I'm going to do over here, I'm gonna remove this held view model, and now here you can see this is our loading case. And when you open up this thing in interactive mode, so this is our loading case. Similarly, if I pass here error, instead of loading, I'm gonna use here error. This is error. Now here you can see this is our error state. Now if you want to see the success state, you can simply use here data, and in place of this is error, I'm gonna pass this is success. And here you can see now you are able to see the preview of your content. And in this fake composable preview for view model, I'm gonna use my content and simply pass my UI state, and that's it. This is the approach that you can use if you are using view model or dagger hilt in your composable. So this is a very good approach of seeing the previews of your different states. Now let's see how we can use multiple previews on our composable. So for that, go to your card item. So here in the card item preview, on the top of it, we are having previews, and I'm gonna simply copy this thing and paste it. And in place of UI mode night no, I'm gonna use here UI mode night yes. So here you can see we are having two different composable. So basically I'm using two previews on a single composable. That's why we are having two different previews. Now in order to make differentiator, you can use name. So I'm gonna call this night, and on the top of it, I'm gonna call it day. And here you can see we are having night preview and we are having day preview. Let me, here you can see day and night. So just like this, if you are having multiple previews, so instead of writing this thing again and again on the top of our composable, we're going to create a different annotation and use that annotation instead of using this multiple previews on the top of our composable. So in order to do that, I'm going to simply cut this thing out, and on the bottom I'm going to create here annotation class and call this multiple preview, and simply paste your preview on the top of this class. Now instead of using these two previews, you can use multiple previews on the top of our card item previews. That's it. Now you can simply use this split mode, and now you are going to see day and night version of your composable. So it's up to you. If you want to create annotations, you can create it very easily by using this approach. So yeah, that's it for this video. It's a very small video, but at the same time it is very important, because if you are writing any composable and you are not able to see the previews, it's not very easy to debug, it's not very easy to change something in that composable, and due to that reason I'll make this video for you. Although if you like this video, subscribe the channel and also write comment if you are having any problem with previews. Let me know, I will try to solve that problem. Bye.